So in today's class, let us continue the discussion of evaluating line integrals over some curve. The first problem is evaluate line integral over C x square plus 2xy square into dx plus x square y square minus 1 into dy. And what is your C? C is the curve which is the region bounded by the curves y square equal to 4x and x equal to 1. So our C is a curve which is the region bounded by the boundaries of the region y square equal to 4x and x equal to 1. What is that? Let us see. Let us draw the curve x equal to 1. This is a straight line, right? Here, x equal to 1, x is fixed value. When y is 0, x is 1. Okay? When y is 1, x is 1. When y is 2, x is 2. When y is minus 1, x is 1. So this is the line. This line represents x equal to 1 graph. This red line represents x equal to 1 graph. Okay? Then, what about y square equal to 4x? It's a parabola. Here I will give the values for x. When x is 0, your y is 0, this point. When x is 1, y is 2. Y is equal to plus. See, when x equal to 1, you'll get y square equal to 4. Therefore, y is equal to plus or minus 2. So, plus 2 and minus 2 when x equal to 1. This point. Go on, continue. So, you'll get a parabola like this. But what is the point of intersection of these two curves? See, from the graph, you can see that the point of intersection of these two curves is this. That is 1, 2 and 1, minus 2. If you want to find that one, straight away you can do this. Put x equal to 1 here, right? What you'll get? You'll get y square equal to 4. Therefore, y is equal to plus or minus 2. This is the point of intersection. That's it. You substitute one curve in the other and you'll get the answer. So this is the point of intersection of this curve. Now, this is your x-axis, that is x, see, this is your y-axis, sorry. So on y-axis, you know that x equal to 0. So this line is x equal to 0 and this line is x equal to 1. So your x value is coming from 0 to 1, right? X value is coming from 0 to 1. But what about y? Your y square equal to 4x, therefore y is equal to plus or minus 2 root x. So y varies from plus or minus 2 root x. That means this is y equal to minus 2 root x, and this is y is equal to plus 2 root x. So you have solved this one here. Y is equal to 2 root x. So this line represents y is equal to plus 2 into root x. And this line, y is equal to minus, because it is in the lower part of the y-axis. So this is negative. So y is equal to minus 2 into root x. This gives you minus 2 into root x. So your x varies from 0 to 1 and y varies from minus 2 into root x to plus 2 into root x, only within this curve. See, you cannot say it varies from minus 2 to plus 2. Why? Because you are not considering whole of this, right? This is y equal to plus 2, this is y equal to minus 2 graph. See, y is minus 2 here, so this length, at any point you take, it is minus 2 from x-axis. See, this length, height, plus 2 at any point. So you cannot take whole of this because your curve is only up to this. And this is represented by y is equal to 2 into root x. This is represented by y is equal to minus 2 into root x. And x varies from 0 to 1. Okay. So with all these things, we'll see this. Now, what I'll do is, see, we need line integral over whole of this region, isn't it? We need line integral over complete this. the region bounded by this is your C. So this is your C, region bounded by this. I'll do one thing. I'll call this part as C1 and the straight line part as C2 within this region. Okay. So this represents C1 and this represents C2. And we know that finding the line integral over C, this is complete C, is same as finding the line integral over C1 plus finding the line integral over C2. Instead of finding the line integral over C, I'll find over C1 plus over C2. That gives you same answer. Answer for the line integral over C. But this curve, what is your C1? Your C1 is y square equal to 4x. And what is your C2? It is x equal to 1. So when you say C1, your y square should be equal to 4x. Therefore, your y will be equal to, let me take plus 2 root x, right? Instead of plus or minus. Because I'm taking x from 0 to 1. So I'm replacing y and also I'm finding dy. So that the variable y and dy are replaced in the line integral. Hence, the only variable that will be left out is x and its derivative. Therefore, this reduces to ordinary definite integral. And we know in this region, x varies from 0 to 1. X varies from 0 to 1. So we know the limit of x also. So we can solve this one very easily by making y and dy substituted in this line integral. So what is your derivative of y? 2 into, we know the derivative of root x is 1 by 2 root x. So 2 to get cancelled, so you will get dy is equal to 1 by root x into dx. Let us substitute all these things in the given line integral. So this is your line integral. But we know that here x varies from 0 to 1. X square plus 2x into y square is 4x. We know that. Into dx plus x square into 4x minus 1 into 1 by root x dx, because that is your dy. Now simplify this, you'll get this much. Now this is very easy to integrate because 9 is a constant that will remain same. What is the integral of x square? X cube by 3. What is the integral of 4x to the power of 5 by 2? 4 will remain same. Integral of x to the power of 5 by 2 is x to the power of 5 by 2 plus 1 divided by 5 by 2 plus 1. You know, Nimigotti the formula. What is the integral of x to the power of n? X to the power of n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Because of that, minus x to the power of, same x to the power of n formula. X to the power of n plus 1, that is minus 1 by 2 plus 1 divided by minus 1 by 2 plus 1. And the limit is from 0 to 1. Now, 3, 3 is a 9. 3 will remain. If you simplify this, you will get 7 by 2. Right? And this is minus half plus 1 is half. So you will get half. If you send this one to the numerator, that becomes 2 by 7. 2 into 4 is 8. 8 by 7 will come. If you send this one to the numerator, 2 will come. Apply the upper limit. 1 cube minus 0 cube. So you simply will get 1. Then 8 by 7, constant that will remain same. 1 to the power of 7 by 2 is 1, minus 0 to the power of 7 by 2 is 0, so 1 minus 0 is 1. Similarly, for this one, you'll get 1 to the power of half, which is 1, 0 to the power of half is 0, so you'll get 1. If you simplify this, you'll get 15 by 7. So that means line integral over C1 is 15 by 7. Now let us find line integral over this curve. Right? Along this curve, C2, what is your x? Your x is 1. So, what is your dx? Derivative of x will be 0. So, I'll replace in the given integral x and dx. So, only y will remain. But remember, along this curve, from where to where your y varies? Because it is in this, the orientation is this, in this direction. Your y varies from, what is the starting point for this? It is here. Intersection is this. This region is starting from here along this line. So What is this point? This is minus 2. Y is minus 2. Till where it is going? It is going up to here. What is your y there? It is 2. So your y varies from minus 2 to plus 2. Make all these substitutions in the given integral. So line integral x square plus 2xy square into dx plus this is equal to y varies from minus 2 to plus 2. Substitute this. What is your x? 1 plus 2 into 1 into y square. What is your dx? 0 plus x square into x square is 1. So 1 into y square minus 1 into dy. 0 and anything is 0. Simply this much will remain. What is integral of y square? Again, y to the power of n form. So integral of y to the power of n is y to the power of n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. So y cube by 3 minus integral of 1 is y. Apply the limits. 1 by 3 is constant. 2 cube minus lower limit minus 2 whole cube plus, here there is no plus, minus upper limit 2 minus lower limit minus 2. So minus 2 whole cube is minus 2 cube, which is minus into minus plus, minus into minus plus. So this is 4. This is 8 plus 8, 16 by 3. If you take LCM, you will get 4 by 3. So area over this line integral, area that is line integral over this region is 4 by 3. Now see, in the first part, you might be wondering, because you are having y square equal to 4x, I've replaced this one by y is equal to 2 into root x. And I've found dy and I've substituted. Can't we solve this one for x? If you take x here, right, your x will be equal to y square by 4, which is y square. If you differentiate this, you will get 2y into dy, which is equal to 4 into dx. Then your dx will be equal to this. But here, y varies from where to where? It is from minus 2 root x to plus 2 root x. So that will be a variable limit. Right? So you cannot substitute that one. We want a fixed value for constants for the limits. Okay? That's the reason we have considered x in that. Now, we know that total line integral is line integral over c1 plus line integral over c2. And this is 15 by 7 plus 4 by 3. And its LCM gives you 73 by 21. So this is how you have to solve the problem when they are given of this kind. First, you need to draw the curve so that you will get point of intersection. If you are unable to find point of intersections right away, what you do is substitute one curve in the other. You'll get point of intersection. See, here x equal to 1, put that one here. You'll get y square equal to 4. That gives you y is equal to plus or minus 2. So when x equal to 1, this is y equal to plus 2 and minus 2. At those two points, it intersects. That is meaning. Okay. Now let's move on to another problem. What is that? Compute line integral of this around the ellipse x square by 9 plus y square by 4 equal to 1 in the counterclockwise direction. In the counterclockwise direction. See, here we know that what is the standard form of an equation of an ellipse with center at the origin. So it is given by x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1, where a is the radius along x-axis and b is the radius along y-axis, right? So if you write 9 as 3 square and 4 as 2 square, then your a will be 3 and b will be 4. So they are given an ellipse with center at origin and x-axis radius 3. See, 3 comma 0, this point, because this is 0 comma 0. Distance between 0 comma 0 and 3 comma 0 is 3. Similarly, distance between minus 3 comma 0 and origin is 3. So this is your ellipse, end points of the ellipse along x-axis. Similarly, along y-axis, radius is 2. So 0 comma 0 to 0 comma 2. distance is 2. 0 comma 0 to 0 comma minus 2, distance is 2. So this is the point of intersection of axis with ellipse. And they are saying the region C is around the ellipse. So this is your region, right? Whenever circle or ellipse comes, it is always good to use the parametric equation of circle and ellipse. What is the parametric equation of circle? A circle with center x1, y1 and radius r is equal to, is given by x equal to x1 plus r cos theta and y is equal to y1 plus r sin theta. Similarly, an ellipse with center x1, y1 is given by x equal to x1 plus a cos theta, y is equal to y1 plus b sin theta. But here center is what? Origin. Therefore, the parametric equation of this general equation becomes x equal to a cos theta, y is equal to b sin theta. And remember, theta varies from, theta is 0 here, right? Because they are given in the counterclockwise direction. So theta is 0. So 0 to 2 pi. Theta varies from 0 to 2 pi total. So 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to 2 pi. That is the limit for theta. Right? Is that right? So this line is theta equal to 0. Take it in the counterclockwise direction. Move it. Again, it comes here. Pi by 2 plus pi by 2 plus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. So 4 pi by 2 means 2 pi. So theta takes 2 pi angle. Okay. Now, using this, we'll solve. Let us write the parametric equation of the ellipse. So, as I said, parametric equation of this is x equal to a is 3, so 3 cos theta, y is equal to b is 2, so 2 sin theta, and theta varies from 0 to 2 pi. So, I'm having x and y and theta. X and y are dependent on theta. So, I have to replace everything in the line integral in terms of theta, right? But while replacing x and y, I have to replace dx and dy also. So let's find out dx. What is the derivative of x? 3 into derivative of cos is minus sine theta into derivative of theta is d theta. Dy is equal to 2 cos theta into d theta. So make these substitutions in the given line integral. And in the line integral, x, y, dx, dy are replaced by terms of theta. Therefore, your line integral reduces to ordinary definite integral involving the variable theta, where theta varies from 0 to 2 pi. So this line integral changes to, you have to apply this method whenever ellipse, circle, when they are given as a curve, for all those problems, it's good to use them in parametric form. It's very easy to solve. So theta varies from 0 to 2 pi. What is your x? 3 cos theta plus 2 into. What is your y? 2 sin theta multiplied by dx minus 3 sin theta d theta plus 4 minus 2 into x is 3 cos theta into dy is 2 cos theta d theta. Multiply them. Minus 3 sin theta into 3 cos theta is minus 9 cos theta into sin theta. Minus 3 sin theta into 4 sin theta is minus 12 sin square theta. 2 cos theta into 4 is 8 cos theta. 2 cos theta into 6 is minus 12 cos square theta. Now, I'll multiply and divide this term by 2. Right? What I have done is multiplied and divide this one by 2. So 2 sin theta cos theta into minus 9. And in these two terms, I have taken minus 12 as common. So sin square theta plus cos square theta is remaining. And the last term is 8 cos theta. But we know that 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta. and sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. Now this is very easy to integrate this one because I've eliminated the product. So it's very easy to integrate. Minus 9 by 2 is constant. That will remain as it is. What is the integral of sine? Yes, it is minus cos 2 theta divided by the term associated with theta is 2. Minus 12 into what is the integral of 1 with respect to theta? Theta. Plus 8, integral of cos theta is sine theta, and the limit is from 0 to 2 pi. Now, minus into minus plus 9 by 4 will remain. I'll apply the upper limit. Cos 2 into 2 pi minus cos 0 minus 12 into 2 pi minus 0 plus 8 into sine 2 pi minus sine 0 lower limit. But you know that cos 4 pi is also the same as cos 0. So this is 1 and this is also 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. And this is minus 24 pi plus 8 into sine 0 is 0. Sine 2 pi is also 0. So this gives you minus 24 pi. So this is how you have to solve the problem when they are given ellipse or circle. You draw the graph and see the condition whether you are taking theta from 0 to 2 pi or some part of that 0 to 2 pi. Depending on that, you have to make substitutions in parametric form and you have to simplify the line integral and bring it to a ordinary definite integral. Fine. Let's move on to the next one. Evaluate line integral over C, x plus y plus z into ds, where s is the arc length of the given curve C and C is the line joining of the points 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. So what they had given is, they had given a curve C, which is the joining of these two points in the space because it is three-dimensional. So it is a line joining of two points in the space. Right? Space means 3D. X-axis, Y-axis and Z-axis. Right? So what is the equation of the line joining of two points in the space? Yes, we know the general equation of line joining of two points in the space. X1, Y1, Z1 and X2, Y2, Z2 is given by x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1, y minus y1 divided by y2 minus y1, z minus z1 divided by z2 minus z1. Right? You have to substitute, you have to take one of them as x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2, substitute it and call that one as some t. Whenever such a problem is given, you have to call the equation, this equation as some t and you have to simplify. So that's how it goes on continuous. But what about this S? Yes, you are familiar with the formula for arc length of the curve. You know how to find it, right? Yeah, you have to use that one. So your D is, you know how to find the derivative of arc length. You are having a formula for that. You have to use that one, the one which you have studied in the first semester, right? But before entering it, whenever ds is given, you have to use that s. You have to remember s is the arc length of the given curve. Even though if they are not mentioned, it is the arc length of the given curve C. Okay. Now, let us find out the equation of line joining these two points C. So, I have substituted your x1 is 1, y1 is 2, z1 is 3, x1 is 1, 2, 3, and x2, y2, z2 is 4, 5, 6. Simplify that. You'll get x minus 1 by 3, y minus 2 by 3, z minus 3 by 3 is equal to. Let us call this one as t. You have to assume. You can give any variable. I've substituted that one as t. Okay. Now, since these three are equal, these two are also equal to each other. So x minus 1 by 3 equal to t implies cross multiply. You'll get x minus 1 equal to 3t. Therefore, x equal to 3t plus 1. Since these two are also equal, y minus 2 by 3 is equal to t implies y minus 2 is equal to 3t. That means y is equal to 3t plus 2. Since these two are also equal, implies z equal to 3t plus 3. So that means we got x, y, z in terms of t. Therefore, your x, y, z is dependent on t. Therefore, t is the independent variable. But what is the limit of that t? That we have to find. For that, we know that our x, y, z varies from 1, 2, 3 to 4, 5, 6. You have to use this condition. When x equal to 1, y is equal to 2, z equal to 3, you know that this is our t. So put x equal to 1 in this. 1 minus 1 by 3, 0. Put y is equal to 2. 2 minus 2 by 3 is 0. Put z equal to 3. 3 minus 3 by 3 is 0. So your t is 0. So when x equal to 1, y equal to 2, z equal to 3, your t is nothing but 0. So instead of this, I can use t equal to 0. Now similarly, substitute 4, 5, 6 in this. When x equal to 4, 4 minus 1, 3, 3 by 3, 1. When y equal to 5, 5 minus 2, 3, 3 by 3 is 1. 6 minus 3, 3, 3 by 3 is 1. So your t will be equal to 1. So instead of writing 4, x, y, z is 4, 5, 6, I can write t equal to 1. So we are having x equal to 3t plus 1, y is equal to 3t plus 2, z equal to 3t plus 3, and t varies from 0 to 1. Now let us find out dx, dy, dz. Your dx will be derivative of this, 3 into dt. If you send this one, dx by dt is 3. dy by dt will be 3. dz by dt will be 3. So we got dx, dy, dz. Right? So we are having a curve C, which is the line joining of these two, which is given by x equal to 3t plus 1, y is equal to 3t plus 2, z equal to 3t plus 3, where t varies from 0 to 1. Right? So in this fashion, you can write. Now, let us substitute these in the line integral. But in the line integral, they had given ds. So let us find out what is the derivative of the arc length. So since s is the arc length, we have ds by dt, because your t is the independent variable. Ds by dt is equal to, this is a standard formula. This square root should be up to here only. Okay. So ds by dt whole square plus dy by dt whole square plus dz by dt whole square. Remove this part. This is not there. Okay. It is only up to this. Okay. So what is your ds by dt? It is square root of dx by dt whole square plus dy by dt whole square plus dz by dt whole square. But you know that what is your dx by dt, dy by dt, dz by dt, substitute them, simplify that, that gives you root 27. Therefore, ds is equal to root 27 into dt. Make these substitutions in the line integral. So your line integral, x plus y plus z into ds over c, transforms into, here variable is t, so t varies from 0 to 1. You know that this line, c is your line from here to here, which is given by t varying from 0 to 1 in terms of t. So what is your x? 3t plus 1, y 3t plus 2, z 3t plus 3, ds root 27 into dt. That is nothing but 90 plus 6 into dt. Root 27 is constant, I have written outside. Now, what is the integral of this? 9 is constant. Integral of t is t with respect to t is t square by 2. 6 is constant. So integral of 1 is t. Apply the limit. Root 27 into 9 by 2 will remain same. 1 square minus 0 square. 1 square is 1. 1 minus 0 is 1. 1 into 9 by 2 is 9 by 2. Plus 6 into 1 minus 0. 1 minus t is 1 upper limit minus lower limit 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1. So 6 into 1 is 6. Take LCM, you'll get this much. So whenever S is given for that problem, you have to remember, though they are not given, in that case also, your S is the arc length of the given curve. And the formula for finding the ds is ds by d with respect to independent variable which you have assumed is equal to square root of this. Okay, so using that fact you have to solve the problems. And given one problem of that kind here, right, simply they are given curve y is equal to x. Instead of line joining of points, they are straight away given curve y equal to x, right? If you use this, you'll get y is equal to x, right? Now the question is how to further proceed. You assume y equal to x equal as some t. Okay, so you'll get y equal to t and x equal to t. Therefore, dy is equal to dt, dx equal to dt. And you know that x is 0, y is 0. Therefore, t is also 0. When x is 1, y is 1, t is also 1. So t varies from 0 to 1. Using those facts, you solve this. Right? So I'd given three problems. And see this one. This is a triangle. This one is a triangle. Okay. So fine. This is a triangle with vertex 0, 0. So if you draw x-axis and y-axis, this is 0, 0. Okay. Just a minute. This is 0, 0. Okay. And this point, it is 2, 0. Fine. And this point, it is 2, 1. X-axis length, this should be a straight line. See, like this, you have to write. Because x-axis length is 2 on that. Okay. The x-axis length is 2 here also, here also. So this is the point 2, 1. Fine. Sorry. This is your x equal to 2, 1. So this is your A, B, C. Now how you're going to find? Yes. As we have solved a few problems in the previous classes, instead of taking whole of this C, you split this one into piecewise smooth curves. So line joining of two points, 0, 0 and 2, 0. So call this one a C1. Find line integral over this line joining of two points. Call this one a C2, line joining of two points, 2, 0 and 2, 1. Right? Find the line integral over this. And line joining of this, remember you have to direction also. So this will be in this direction, this will be in this direction, this will be in this direction. So line joining of 2 points 2, 1 and 0, 0, you have to use the equation of line joining of two points, which is y minus y1 divided by x minus x1 is equal to x2 minus x1 divided by y2 minus y1. Use that equation and solve it and sum the answer. That is your integral of this over C. Okay. I'd given one more problem here around the unit circle in the counterclockwise direction. So as I said, because it's a circle with center at origin and radius 1, you can use the parametric equation. What is that parametric equation for a circle having a center at origin? Yes, x equal to x1 plus r cos theta, y is equal to y1 plus r sin theta. But x1, y1 is center. But here center is origin. Therefore, x1, y1 is 0. So simply, x equal to r cos theta, y equal to r sin theta. But radius is what here? It is unit circle. So radius is 1. So parametric equation are x equal to cos theta, 1 cos theta, y is equal to 1 sin theta. And theta varies from, because it is in the counterclockwise direction. If it is in the clockwise direction, 2 pi to 0. But in the counterclockwise direction, it is 0 to 2 pi. make all those substitutions and simplify, you'll get the answer. So this is how you have to solve the line integral. When they are given, your curve C is the intersection of two points or intersection of two curves or line joining of two points, etc. So I'll stop at this stage. We'll continue in the next class.